This novel is controversial, totally bonkers. In a political and social sense, there will be some lingering questions in your mind. Psychedelic experiences, check it out. Hey guys, welcome aboard Wallflower Express. Hope you've all been well. I've been alright, but ever since lockdown started, I noticed that my ability to focus has really been affected. I'm always distracted and I'm always checking out social media. So I realized that I should actually spend more time reading books. And these five books in particular have helped me recharge and get my mojo back. So let me share them with you. Okay, first we have Ghostwritten by David Mitchell. You're probably familiar with David Mitchell because he wrote Cloud Atlas and that was adapted into the big screen. The premise of the book is that this spirit jumps from body to body and then it sort of views life from the perspective of the people that it inhabits. Based from that concept, it already fascinated me. Then when I started to read it, I was amazed even more because there were so many characters. You have your doomsday cult member in Okinawa, like a jazz music lover in Tokyo, a ghostwriter in London, a Danish backpacker in Mongolia, a tea shack owner in Holy Mountain, and a lot more. What I really liked about it is it helped me understand how the world works. It made me grasp how we're wired as human beings, how factors like age, nationality, gender, and class all contribute to the way that we think and deal with things. There will be some lingering questions in your mind, like what does the ghost really want? Is there really hope to restore faith in humanity? For me, it's highly recommended and check it out. So next we have Vert, written by Jeff Noon. Vert is about Scribble. He's looking for his sister Desdemona and he's helped by his gang. They're all living in an alternate reality of Manchester, a cyberpunk kind of world which reminds me of Blade Runner and Altered Carbon. Everyone in this world has access to Vert, which is a mind-altering drug. It's actually a feather that looks like this. And you shove it down your throat. Then after a few moments, you'll have psychedelic experiences. The only difference between Vert and psychedelics is that you'll get to share the alternate reality, virtual reality experience with whomever you're doing it with. That's how Scribble lost his sister. They shared a trip together and after the trip, she was gone. Scribble is convinced that there's this sort of contraband yellow feather type of Vert that will lead him back to his sister. While I was reading it, it really piqued my curiosity. I asked myself, you know, will Scribble ever find his sister? And is Vert good or bad for society? Is it worth it to escape from reality? So third, we have The Master and Margarita by Mikhail Bulgakov. I hope I pronounced that correctly. This novel is controversial. It's a Russian classic. It was written in the 1930s, but it was only published in the 1960s. It's about the devil and two of his companions, a female vampire and a talking cat, and they visit atheistic Soviet Union, specifically Moscow, and they sort of debate with intellectuals and writers and elites during that time. And then the second part takes us to a mental institution where we meet the master who is obsessed with Pontius Pilate. He writes a book about Pontius Pilate and about the time when he approved the execution of Jesus. We also meet Margarita, who is the master's lover, and then the devil tries to strike a deal with her, but I won't say what it is because I don't want to be a spoiler. To me, the whole dynamic is very interesting and it's really refreshing because it's written in a magical realism sort of way. I could also detect like hints of satire while I was reading it because a lot of serious things were discussed. It depicted the political climate and the religious climate of Soviet Union during that time, but it was told in like a light-hearted, fun way. So to me, that's really fascinating and quite bonkers, actually. Totally bonkers, but in a good way. If you're into bonkers things that would make you think, then I guess you will like this as well. Next, we have Noli Me Tangere by Dr. Jose Rizal. So, Dr. Jose Rizal is the national hero of the Philippines. He's a brilliant man. This book actually inspired Filipinos during that time to revolt against the Spaniards. And this was written in 1887. It's about Crisostomo Ibarra, a half Filipino, half Spanish man who spent 7 years abroad studying. Then he comes back to the Philippines and witnesses all the social cancers in the country. That includes hypocrisy by friars, behaving immorally, racism in our own country, the thirst for change and revolution, which was exactly what this novel achieved. And because of that, Dr. Jose Rizal was executed by firing squad. So he really died for the message of this book, and that's why I think it's so powerful and so meaningful. And more than that, I think the social cancers depicted in this book are still relevant up to this day and age, especially in a political and social sense in the Philippines. I think this really reignited my nationalism, my patriotism. It reminded me about the importance of dissent and freedom from fascist elements. I think it's worth looking back to Noli Me Tangere for any Filipino out there. And even if you're non-Filipino, I think you will appreciate this because of its powerful revolutionary message. Lastly, we have Absolutely On Music, which is a collaboration between Japanese author Haruki Murakami and Boston Symphony Orchestra conductor Seiji Ozawa. So it's a non-fictional work, and I really liked it because of its sort of Q&A format. It's basically conversations between Murakami and Ozawa. They talk about classical music from Beethoven to Brahms, and then they deconstruct records which they listen to together. And they talk about orchestra, film scores, jazz clubs, everything about music and how it impacted their lives. It culminated in Murakami's 10-day visit to Geneva to witness the musical workshop of Ozawa for young musicians. It was really cool, and I think you'll like it as well if you appreciate music. If you want to get into the minds of two masters, a musical master and a literary master. So it's the best of both worlds. And that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you like my 5 recommendations. And if you have some book recommendations as well, let me know in the comments below. See you again next time. Like and subscribe. Bye!